Let's try that again. Thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to be drawing Augustine of Hippo with this new quote here. And what else? What's up with you guys? How's everyone doing? I'm drinking chocolate milk and spilling all over myself while I get ready. Well, that was graceful, wasn't it? All right. So, this is a quote from Augustine's Confessions. My wife Stephanie has been working through that book recently, and she sent me some quotes. This was one of them. I thought it was really good. Not with doubting, but with assured consciousness, do I love thee, Lord. Thou hast stricken my heart with thy word, and I loved thee. Hey! What's up? Dust and Ashes View. And good day, man. Augment. Hope y'all are doing well. We're getting dumped on with snow today, so it's been pretty exciting watching all of that come down. It is nuts out there. Trying to get my brush back in order. I changed it up a little bit earlier today, and I'm just trying to get it back in order to where it was, to where I want it to be. So, there it is. Okay. So, I don't know. My thoughts for this one were to do something simple. So I have this idea of Augustine laying on his hippo's back, reading the Bible. I'm not sure how it's gonna work, if it'll work, but we'll see. Yeah, I changed the name from Dush's View to Dust and Ashes View. Makes a little more sense, if I'm honest. Well, it's good to see you again. It's been a long time, I feel like. And it's been a long time since I've drawn any new Augustine illustrations. So I'm just starting out, just scribbling around, trying to figure this out. Not happy with that one. Maybe instead here. Might help if I just take off the text first. Or just move it. Stephanie just sent me another quote. For a happy life is joy in the truth, for this is a joying in thee, who art the truth, O God, my light, health of my countenance, my God.
That's pretty good.
Hey, Levid. How you doing? Thanks for popping in here. Yeah. I think I asked you what Dush's view meant as well. Well, it's good to be back doing stuff online again. let's see. How about, what if I just do, so if you saw the John Calvin post I did today, it was just an image of John Calvin next to a quote. It's kind of a similar idea of what I'm going to do for this one. I'm using OBS for my live. I've been working on it, getting some new things for it and new plugins and whatnot, trying to figure out what's going to work for me for going live. And I'm testing out this plugin that actually just came out like within the last month for streaming live from my computer to Instagram. So right now I'm streaming live on Instagram and on YouTube. Hello.
Are you live?
Yeah.
Did you see my message?
Yeah, for the quote.
Another one?
Yeah, I read it on live.
Yeah.
That was good.
Are you on YouTube?
I mean, YouTube and Instagram.
I don't see you on YouTube. Does anybody else see you on YouTube?
Let me check. Yeah.
Huh.
I'm on YouTube. Yeah, because I have comments. Augment from YouTube commented, and yeah, I'm on YouTube, right?
Okay. I'm probably in the wrong place.
That's all right. I probably did something wrong too, because I usually do.
Well, I was just gonna.
It's just the nature of this.
Put it on in the background, but man, it's good, right, Paul? It's good. What?
It's good. Oh, what's the plugin name? Dust and Ashes is asking. So the plugin name is, what is it? Something vertical. Vertical something, just a minute. Vertical scenes, vertical sources. It's by a company called, Aitum, A-I-T-U-M, I think is how you pronounce it, or how you spell it. And yeah, Aitum, A-I-T-U-M. It is called Aitum Vertical Plugin for OBS 29 Plus. And you just go to aitum.tv, and it's right there. And it's free. They have other services that are paid, but this one is a free plugin. You can stream live on Instagram, and you can, there's a special button you can, I can show you the plugin right now, actually. Whoosh. Look at that. So this right here, this plugin, I can backtrack like however long I want. So like I push this button and it'll save a backtrack. I have it set to go 2 minutes behind. So you can use those that backtrack video and post it as a short on YouTube or Instagram, wherever, as a vertical video, but you can also record your regular video as well. It's a really cool thing. You can even link your scenes between the vertical and horizontal videos. So if you switch a scene in the horizontal and that scene is linked to another scene in the vertical, it'll switch on the vertical as well. So I don't think there's anything else like it out there. And it is pretty sweet. I've really been enjoying it. Yeah, no problem. So right now, this is the idea phase, and it is messy, messy, messy. I need some more of my milk. Whenever we finish up a bottle of chocolate syrup, I always claim it and put milk in it. Shake it around and get all the rest of the stuff out in chocolate milk. Okay. I believe everyone else had ice cream. I did not. Because all we have is mint chocolate chip, and I do not like mint chocolate chip anymore. I'm not crazy about that either. Let's try another one. I should find a drawing that I did of the hippo. Oh, one moment, please. Ah, here we go. This might work. Nope. There. That'll help me. Maybe a little bit. Maybe it'll help me. We'll see. Oh no. So you stopped doing lives, huh? Because you couldn't plug in your camera? I have my phone plugged in. Now that the Apple products have the what's it called? Continuity camera. My iPhone can act as a what's it called? Another camera. Because my other external camera, I have a C920 and a Logitech C920, and that is just not good. Oh, or your microphone. Yeah, I've been using the same setup ever since I started, a few years until now. I have that iPhone now as my camera. The Logitech is just so grainy, and now the support for it is no longer there, so I upgraded my system, and now I can't get the program to work on my computer, the program that allowed me to change the color tones and autofocus and things like that. It's no longer available on my computer system. So that computer is now, or that camera is now out of commission. I forgot how I drew him. I don't necessarily want to draw him the same pose, but I want to get him right. Yeah, I'm drawing him not round enough. So I need a bigger circle. Kind of like that. And I'm going to make him so he's walking. There we go. All right, great to see you too. Get back to work now. actually going to give him like a happy, a jolly walk. He's kind of leaning to one side, his head up, putting his foot out to walk. Give him an open mouth. It'll make him a little bit more different than what we're used to seeing. There we go. Woo-hoo. You know what? I don't think I'm gonna give him a harness. I think he can just be free to roam. He's a jolly hippo. There we go. So he's a lot rounder than I typically think to start off drawing him as. So, and he has 3 feet because you can't see his fourth foot. It's back there a ways. Because he's stepping with both feet on each side. Now I can draw Augustine on his back reading a book. Reading the word. Let's see if that's going to work, actually. Guess I don't need that anymore. It looks like the hippo has a bow. Fix that. Well, let me make this a little more straight so we can actually see the book cover and see that it says Holy Bible on it. Not very versed in how I'd draw Augustine, so this may take a few tries. Or maybe not. Turning the page, and we'll put a cross on the back just so we know what it is. I'll take that one off. Pardon me? Okay. Here's the full quote. I think his pose on the hippo is still a little off. So I'm gonna work on that. Wow. wonder if also the hippo could be a little squished. There we go. What's the hippo's name? I think long time ago on Alive, we figured his name was Lloyd. If you have a different name for the hippo, let me know. What do you think the hippo's name should be? Purple hippo. Augustine's hippo. Henry. Harvey. I don't know, I naturally gravitate towards the names that start with H. Well, anyway, let me know if you think of a name for our hippo friend here. Otherwise, I'll just stick with Lloyd. Maybe I'll have both his feet up in the air like this. All right, let's try that. Now, I'm gonna finalize these lines. See how this goes. Okay. Big old gust of wind blowing all the snow all over the place. That's crazy. Man. I thought our snow was done because everything was getting warm. Everything was melting. But I should have known. February in Wisconsin.
Lustig Park.
What about it?
They have a very large sledding hill and we have a very large amount of snow.
Yes, they do.
My suggestion is as follows. Can we go?
Can we go? Yeah.
We are with you or just me and the kid?
I can go.
It is 3:37.
Okay.
I don't care if we wait for a little bit because Harper, her hair will have to dry before we go outside.
Okay.
How goes it?
Good.
Did it settle on something?
Yeah, I think so.
Is it riding the hippo?
No.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you had him laying down on it.
He is.
I mean, like, in front of it.
Oh.
The both of them. What did you?
I did. I was sketching out ideas. I didn't like any of those, though.
Mm-hmm. Looks rather jolly.
Yeah.
I'm on paragraph or whatever, 42.
Oh, yeah.
Out of 70. It's gonna make my eyes cross if they aren't already, man. Oof. Do you want to go when the snow settles down after 6? Or do you want to go while it's snowing?
We can go while it's snowing, that's fine. Okay.
Do I ask friends?
See.
Huh?
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna check the temperature too because if it's terribly cold, going down that big hill is gonna be miserable.
Right.
27. Oh, it's snowing until 8 p.m. So we don't want to miss anything. Yeah, it looks like it.
Like we're going sledding. Alright. So there is that. Next thing I want to do is I want to come up with a background for this. Broken up too strangely. This word is just so large. The word consciousness, it breaks up the text so much that I don't know what to do with it here. There, if I separate it into two lines, it works a little better here. I could put it right here, right in the middle. So that kind of curves around his nose there. Then, for a background, so I like to do like these torn up parchment papers for the background. So let's try that. I wonder if I should create some sort of like pebble road. That he's walking on. Hey, long time no see. From Jesus Followers Women Ministries. Bible Brothers, hello. How you doing? let's get this background drawn in. Now we'll do a separate layer for those little stones on the ground. All right, so now that I have all the inks drawn in, I can get rid of all these pencil lines. Then I will be able to color this. Center this into the frame right there, and voila, there are the inks for this Augustine quote. Now all I have to do is add the colors and we're good to go. But now I think I'm gonna go sledding with my family because it is nice and snowy outside. We got a ton of snow today, like it was, we just got dumped on. I really thought the huge gusts coming off of the roof, I really thought the snow was done, but it's not. So we're going to go enjoy that together. Don't forget, check out RefToons.com. Actually, today I updated the website. I had to change the theme all around because the old theme that I had was no longer supported. So I switched that up. It's a new theme on the website. So things will look a little different if you haven't been there in a while. And I also added some product videos to some of the products so that you can actually see what the products look like from all different sides. So you get a better idea of what you're getting into when you buy something. So thank you again, everyone, for tuning in. And I will catch you all next time. Have a good day.